G'day, mate. Welcome to Austral. We're here in Australia in the land down under. I didn't expect for them to skip the grid. But they advanced a minute early, so we're here. The Shane Van Gisbergen Stock Car Showdown from the wonderful Sandown International Motordrome Velodrome Motorplex. And I'm joined in the booth. Oh, Joe Armstrong's off the grid. I'm joined in the booth by some lovely people. As always. Let's find out who they are. It is Ben Billard, Josh Cronin, and Josh Morgan. Hello.
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 How's it going?
Yep.
We're actually about to get going, because this is a standing start.
We sure are, and I what?
I'm not sure screen.
Oh, sorry, I didn't realize that I wasn't.
Oh, no, it is.
Okay,
oh.
I was going to say. I literally
am. All the lights.
Oh, I think they're about to go.
They're
so,
of course, we're going.
So
hey,
Jonathan,
he's on pole.
Joe Armstrong. There it is.
This is a really good production quality. Oh, that's not Rudy Valentin. There he is. Wow.
There he is.
Rudy Valentin making his season debut, I believe.
Yeah, in that 78 car. There he is. There's Triffin Davis. Oh. Jonathan Oates isn't on the grid yet. I guess they're stalling, because Jonathan Oates is not on the grid yet, I guess, on purpose.
He's doing a little trolling.
Triffin Davis is there. I just realized that the screen is still upside down, but I'm going to keep it at least for a little bit until...
Until lights out.
It's a quick little. It's like, oh shit! It's like, oh fuck! It's a quick.
Ethan Stanley out. Also making his OSRL debut.
That's not true.
That's not true. When was the last time he raced?
Las Vegas, I think. No.
I think so. I believe so.
Hello, Christian Gamboa, league sponsor of the Austral AA Solutions LA Premier Series.
William Schmidt in another new paint scheme.
This is another new paint scheme for Jack Painter. One of my favorites of the night.
We skipped by the Rudy Valentin in the AU Factory Ford Falcon. Ethan Quarter in the 888 Race Engineering Vodafone. I think it's a Chevrolet this week. I like the blacked out headlights on it with the Komatsu on it. It looks really good.
Gibson's back here. He's not in a special car. Michael Rosario is in the Bill Lester machine. Ooh, that's different. That's
he's in the Kmart Commodore. Hell yeah. Is that the Greg Murphy lap of the
Yes,
car?
It Greg is.
Greg Murphy. He's going to...
That might be the Greg Murphy. That is the Greg Murphy lap of the gods car. Hell yeah. W. Hey, who else?
Joshua Stoltz is in the modern Shane Van Gisbergen machine, the Ampol Red Bull Holden Commodore.
Unbelievable.
David Cabrera's here.
There he is. That's him, David Cabrera.
Cole Frelich is here. AJ Green is here in the iconic Def Leppard machine.
Yep.
Brian Lindauer's here. Griffin Jones is here in that car. Omar Perry's here. Bobby Blazer's here. Big fan, once again, big fan of that number font.
It really is.
It's I enjoy it. It's unique. I like it. I haven't seen that before. It's different. Gavin Newton's here. Tommy Cook's here. He's revving up. It startled me for a second. I thought they were about to go. Okay, Jonathan Oates is on the grid, so I'm gonna say that they're about to go. So I'm gonna change this.
Jonathan Oates is in the Godzilla car.
I'm gonna change this.
Shame that there's a Nissan template and you didn't use it.
Yeah, the Skyline throwback.
So now all you lovely, cool cats and kittens can see everything that's happening.
Well, it's awesome.
Let's go back to the grid pole thing, because it's just
progressivism
cool,
win.
Man.
Oh yeah, it's a standing start. That'll be fun.
Yeah, it's going to be very interesting going down here in turn one. Sandown is a racetrack. It's very interesting. And
it's true. It's got a certain amount of turns.
Technically, it's got 13.
They're revving.
They're about to get going their way here.
Oh.
One light. Two lights. Three lights. Okay. Guto sends us off for racing.
We race.
Oh, they're about to go three wide up here for third or second. See if they can survive turn one. Oh
no. Back. Oh trouble.
I think it was Michael Rosero facing the wrong way.
Maybe yellow on the speedway.
And as expected, caution out in turn one, lap one. The SVG stock car showdown. Let's take a look. There were some corners missed.
My. Well, that was one of them.
Josh Gosselin went around as well.
How do you do that?
We saw another car a little further up. That was 81. That was Scott Sobczak.
So there's a lot. So Scott Sobczak misses the corner. Gibson misses the corner, but he doesn't actually hit anybody. Ethan Corder may have helped him there. And then there's about 15 other people that have separate incidents that aren't related. There's about 15 different incidents that occurred in that corner.
I just want to say to Scott I'm 100% fucking up your last name. Feel free to let me know how it's pronounced if you are watching this at any time.
Yeah, it was kind of like the exit apex on the right just got blocked by two cars facing sideways, so everybody had to scramble either right to the grass or left to try and avoid it, and just kind of caused a lot of mayhem.
They're under caution. Joe Armstrong has met the iRacing.com Porsche safety car.
Effective use of it. Got back out there real quick.
Yeah.
That also bailed out Rudy Valentin, who we saw didn't get the best launch off the line. Was about to get taken three by Triffin and Jonathan Oates. Oates backed out, but Rudy was still on the... I think there's something going on in Connecticut right now.
Is there?
I'm hearing sirens.
Oh, that's not good.
You know.
My headphones must be really good because I didn't hear them. But I did see the light clipping.
Yeah, so Rudy was on the outside on not the preferred line for a lap one, turn one melee, and only lost the one position so far. So hopefully Rudy can get that behind him. He's now got a second chance to try and get after Joe Armstrong, who had a really good start.
Trying to still get the camera set up for this track, or just like see what's correct.
I mean, it's also a good time to
skill
talk about the track map, as it were,
The track itself, yeah.
So we are on the back straight right now. It is a 13-turn circuit, technically, even though the last turn is kind of like a little bit of a kink right before you get the start-finish line, and turn five is like a little bit of a kink on the back straight that we were just on. It's a 3.15-kilometer circuit, and it's kind of built in the way where all the technical bits, like the 6, 7, 8, 9 sections on one end of the track, there's a long straightaway, and then there's another technical section of the track, which we saw at the start with the 1, 2, 3, and 4 section. It's only a 40-lap race, so it's about, 120-ish kilometers?
Something like that.
This probably does help a lot for the fuel situation, because you always see with the OSRL races that fuel is a question for these road races. But with the heavy braking zones in the turn 1 and the turn 6, it does help a lot that you can kind of lift and coast a little bit. So fuel is going to be a definite question, but if you're going to be kind of middle of the pack, you're probably going to be wanting to take tires about half distance. And we see a couple people going to the pits for some repairs early on.
Griffin Jones, Jack Painter, receiving Sir Darius Daggars there. Wow.
Oh, yeah.
There's Harry. Harry coming off a third place last week. Or was that... That was last week, right?
That was last week.
Hey, you know what my pick is for this race? My pick is Darius Daggar. He's going to win this race. That's everybody's picks. We never did picks.
I rudely interrupted. I mean, technically, there's... we got plenty of time to do our picks here, so I'm gonna go ahead and pick. I'm gonna pick Joe. Who is he? He's gonna win this race.
He's leading though.
He has to win a race eventually. He runs every one. He finished second in the points last year. He has to. They're doubling up, by the way. They're gonna go green.
The Mark Martin effect.
He has to win a race.
He has to.
It's the reverse Mark Martin, because he hasn't even. He's better in the championship than he is at winning races.
I'm gonna go with Ethan Quarter. He's gonna extend his points lead tonight.
I'm still going with Darius Daggar. Just wait, he's got something for him in the late game. Trust me.
Darius Daggar is back there all the way in the 28th position, ass last.
Yep.
He came in for service, I believe.
He's going to do a 2007 Mexico Montoya.
Yep.
Like the Busch series.
Plausible, actually.
It was from 20th to 2nd and then takes out Scott Pruitt.
That was totally justified, by the way.
Honestly, it was pretty epic. Worked his way all the way back up there at the end of the race and then just destroyed Scott Pruitt.
So we're going to go back green here. Joe Armstrong is your leader. Triffin Davis has hopped up onto the front row. There's Ben Billard. Hello.
Hello.
How's it going?
Good.
It's probably going to be pretty interesting again here.
Oh, yeah, because now they're going to be going even faster.
Yeah, they're going really fast this time.
Oh, my.
Oh, they're gonna fan out here.
Do it again. Do it again. Do it again. Do it again.
Oh, man. Oh, they're trying.
AJ Green a little bit out of shape. So is Gavin Newton.
Oh, he's 48s.
Gavin Newton still with the back and forth after having him at IRP all the time. But so far, we're handling this first section of corners pretty well here.
It is very tight, as you can see, for these ARCA cars to get through this stretch of racetrack. Got a battle for second here, Triffin Davis and Rudy Valentin, and that'll be Valentin taking away the position.
It looks like Triffin might have clipped the grass on the back straight, decided to just let Rudy go there. Braden Mubbich has moved up the fourth past Jonathan Oates. And then we got Ethan Quarter and Wesley Person rounding out the top six.
And he had the braking zones right where the camera is.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is the so-called turn 13 or whatever. It's not much of a turn, really.
Man, it is still a turn.
Oates has lost another position, I think.
He's washed.
He's only back to sixth.
I think Ethan Quarters missing in view as well. He was up here.
Oh, Ethan Quarters
near the front.
In the pits.
He's
what happened?
He had a penalty?
Did he?
Did he change lanes on the restart, maybe?
I guess something had to have happened. Let's take a look at the in-game. Oh, my God. Ethan Quarter was given an EOL penalty. Oh.
It might have been for causing the yellow.
It might have been, but you don't have to pit with an EOL. Oh, no, hang on. I know what he might be doing.
Do you think that he's pitting for fuel?
I believe he is pitting for fuel.
He was in pits.
I was told, consulting with multiple drivers, that a tank is 38 laps. Now, I mean, that's irrelevant because we just did like 4 laps of yellow. They probably saved a bit. Perhaps trying the long con.
They have gotten spread out awfully quick here.
I'll figure it out.
Battling back here, though, in the 20s. Michael Rosero, Josh Gosselin, they were both involved in that lap one wreck.
I wonder how much how big the draft is on the straight. He's hard on the brakes up the inside. Gets it done. That is actually really well executed. I mean, he hits those comically large exit curves there through one. He's going to keep on trucking. Ooh, maybe a bit wide there. This doesn't seem like a track where you want to use the curbs.
Yeah.
No, like they're actually like comically tall. Like on they almost look like they're like pointed. Not even like round.
At least for these Arca cars, they are.
Yeah.
You especially don't want to use them in the next section of corners. That's Gavin Newton's on the grass.
Oh, and he is not making this corner.
Wide into no man's land.
It's just a straight line. How did he hit the grass?
That used to be grass before this iteration of Sandown got scanned. He would have been sent straight into the barriers on his right, and that would have been a nasty hit for the Gavin's 48 machine.
Why don't they use the horse racing track? Is that James D. Gibson and who is that?
That is James D. Gibson and David Cabrera.
I was going to say David Cabrera.
Oh, and Gibson completely blows the corner. He's going to lose 2-3 spots out of that.
That was bad, too, because not only did he lose time and positions, but he also probably lost tire life.
Yeah, he locked the shit out of those things up.
A lot of the slow speed corners here, so I don't know how bad the tire wear is going to be. However, this car does still weigh about 50 million pounds.
Yeah, these fucking stock cars are heavy as shit.
He did get a good job out of the last, I think it was turn 4, to get the crossover on Sojak to regain one of the positions he's lost. Now he's stuck in 11th. Now we're looking at Schmidt and Pearson battling for 7th.
Oh, what was that? Was it David Cabrera?
That was Cole Frelick having a little bit of a moment.
How did he do that?
He was all over the place. He was very low on corner exit. Gibson's lost a lot of the time, as has Frelick here. Oh, we got a caution. We got trouble at the back. 3 cars, 4 cars under the barriers.
Perry
Griffin
Grindel.
Jones.
It's gonna be wet in that corner.
Josh Stoltz is involved.
It's raining.
What on earth went on here?
The good news is Ethan Quarters got 3 places.
Oh, we're going to see it happen right here.
Oh, my goodness.
Huh.
Huh. That's a weird one. Huh. Oh, no, pal.
Huh. Interesting wreck.
So, it kind of starts with Michael Rosero trying to navigate past the Mo Perry machine. And then Mo Perry's kind of on like an awkward spot on the exit at turn 12.
I have to see it again. I think it's just somebody slow on exit and the people behind can't react in time.
Yeah, Mo was on the outside kind of in a really awkward spot because he was going to be in the grass and then go straight on into that barrier. And then he just got helped into that barrier by Grindel and Gosselin.
He's probably gone a bit wide to avoid Gavin. Not that Gavin's move was that much of a dive, but he has tried to stay wide, maybe missed his breaking point. And he gets helped, and he's a passenger for a lot of that.
It's a very comical incident.
There's quite literally a period of that incident where he's not on the ground.
Well, and no one really didn't do anything wrong, per se. It's just kind of like a circumstance of the concertina effect. That's a couple free spots for Ethan Corden, and that kind of bails him out after coming to the pits for fuel and tires.
It has saved the, those looking to
that's
stay
your
out
leader.
For the race. Here's the other key, though. Fuel might last 40 laps, or tires?
That's the question with these races, man.
I mean, this track isn't that technical.
Technical? It's a lot of low speed stuff. You're gonna burn up the front outside tire, and that's gonna be the
oh, we got trouble
gear.
With the back.
Oh,
that
my
Tommy
goodness.
Cook?
That is Tommy Cook. What's he doing, man?
Oh, trouble. Oh, well, okay. Well, at least he didn't.
He's okay. He's all right.
I think something broke in that car.
Something might have broken in that thing.
Yeah.
Might be a left rear shock.
It's see the sparks and it just goes red.
You say the tire? Oh, he towed! Unbelievable.
Why'd he tow?
Because something broke. See, he left.
He vacated
the premises immediately.
Tommy, no.
That was so unnecessary.
He just was like, I had enough.
He didn't even hit anything.
I'm out of here. He's fed up.
It was like a month and a half in sea freight for the 200 machine.
Yeah, that shit takes so long for these fucking cars to get down here. We almost missed if the Puffer Zone Network would have missed their flight, then we wouldn't have had a broadcast this week. Oh, they're
it is
a bunch of people pitting.
Oh, they're
tripping jukes out.
Spike. But it's about half and half here.
Amra is the choose cone.
There they are.
They are. Everybody's pitting.
That's Valance and Oates and Stanley. Wesley Pearson, the notables out of the top 10.
I mean, I'm not going to pretend that I'm an ARC expert, but I don't know if this was the call. Why is Ethan back in?
He just needs a lot of fuel, man.
He's probably been tired.
Armstrong's out.
I think was he a part of the wreck at the beginning that like locked it up big?
I don't believe he was. I don't think so. He could have been. Down and away.
That's not the move. I don't know. I don't know what happened there.
Do you want to talk to him?
I mean, sure, it's not urgent, though.
Okay.
Yeah, we also have three extra sets of tires, so smoke them if you got them, I guess.
Ah, fuck, we're talking to him right now.
Yeah, let's talk to him.
Ethan, I got a question for you, buddy. Why'd you stop twice?
What do you mean?
Why'd you stop twice?
I got a penalty, so I had to do a drive-through.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
So you just drove through the first time?
Yeah.
So what'd you do?
I moved him back.
Oh.
Wow.
Like, caused the incident.
Unbelievable. Well, what did he do?
I probably took him out. I don't know. I just why did he tow?
I don't know, man. He's left. He's on a flight back home.
He's gone. He bought this track.
The entire
crew
was like, what the fuck is he doing?
How is Darius still at the back?
He's just pitting, man. Let him live. He's getting fuel.
He didn't even. I don't even think he pit. I saw like 20 cars come in, and the Blahaj machine wasn't in it.
He's fucking pitting.
I was like, yeah, he's gonna get all of his places back, and then he's at the back.
Listen, he's biding his time. Okay.
He's my pick, though.
He's biding his time. We gotta give him time. He'll be there. We're only a quarter of the way through this racing event.
I made two of my picks, and they're both in the last row.
My pick, Joe Armstrong, it was the first car off pit road, is back in 12th. So 12th on back on tires here. First 11 have stayed out. So this will be interesting.
We got Nostril who's who for this.
Triffin Davis and
Restart.
Restart, that's what it is. Triffin Davis is up here. Nostril champion Braden Mavich. 3 wins on the season on the front row to get this kicked off here.
William Schmidt, David Cabrera, AJ Green, Gary Waterworth,
Marty Farrell, Jack Painter, Michael Rosero's back up in ninth, and Josh Gosselin rounds out the top 10.
Well, the fan that was big there at the back, so I bet I got a bad start.
Dave's I think it's three wide with Rosero.
Oh, not going
to no! That was a 24, Marty Farrell getting spun.
He gets hooked around by AJ Green. One car only. We're going to stay green for now. AJ Green works around Harry Grindel with Joe Armstrong right behind him.
Oh, Rudy gets put through the grass. He's okay.
He didn't actually lose that many places.
All right, we found our camera angle.
Yeah, this camera rocks.
We found our cameras.
Well, we're losing vehicles in the trees. There we go.
Oh, there we go.
Oh, Gavin
is this just a drone cam for the whole track?
It's called Dynamic TV One.
I love this.
It's very cool. I'm a fan
of it. All right, this is the camera. We need to run every race for this.
Yeah, we can see Oates kind of let Cole Frelick go there into the 6, 7, 8, 9.
Oh, we got trouble at the front!
AJ Green's in the sand, so is Harry Grindel.
And the caution's
out.
Somebody else was there, sideways there too. It might have been Joe Armstrong.
I think it was Joe Armstrong.
I saw a blue car, and he's not at the front anymore.
There he is. He has to have been involved in this in some way. Damn!
Oh no! What a move!
Pow!
If he had made that stick, that would have been the greatest move in the history of iRacing. The issue is that he was in the process of wrecking.
Oh my goodness!
But it just got away from him there.
Oh my!
I'm gonna say that I thought that wasn't a three car incident for a second, but upon further review, that is a three car incident.
Is there like a normal TV one there that has like the actual like traditional camera? Yeah, it looks like he just clipped the grass on his left, and it just shot him straight.
Who is that behind Joe?
That is Harry Grindel and Ethan Stanley.
The red car. Is that Ethan Stanley in the all red car?
Is. Right there.
Tell you what, that's a lucky man.
Let's take a look at how lucky he is. Woo!
Yeah, that's.
I think he gave Grindel just like a little bit of a boo.
He might have, but I would argue that
like
it didn't break the camel's back. I think it was kind of.
I'm gonna say that wasn't Joe's intention. Let's go on with it here.
He had a heck of a run though. He was kind of committed to it with Grindel on his right flank.
He might have just got unsettled, he just got on the grass and then. Whoopsie.
Trouble.
Well, kudos to him for like waiting for everybody to go by.
Yeah, that's true.
That's just rejoining and murdering a ton of
people. Look at this fucking camera guy.
Yeah,
what a
guy.
Beast. He's just so fucking chilling. He's going up and down. He's yanking it. What a dude.
Guy.
Big shout out to all of our camera guys here at the Public Zone Network. There he is again. You see him.
They're on the same flight as us. We were all just stuck in economy because that's all.
Doing some great work.
We're doing the thing that one race on Speed Channel, I think it was, did when the race was on Halloween. So all the camera guys were wearing masks and stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah.
Like the trackside episode where they were all dressed up.
The famous WTF moments in NASCAR clip.
Yeah.
Like, I think that was the name of the series. Shout out. YouTube user Frisky Nixon. Or WTF moments in IndyCar. That's a certified classic.
What do you think the YouTube user NASCAR Nixon is up to as we... What do you think he's doing right now?
I hope he's editing another Chaotic Caution video.
Do you think that he's editing NASCAR shenanigans number 24?
I think he is.
Or like a shocking moment causing cautions. Moment or something like
that. Was that his name? NASCAR Nixon?
Well, it was NASCAR Nixon, and they changed it to Frisky Nixon.
Unbelievable.
Which I don't know why.
He has an upload 3 days ago. Pop Punk in NASCAR, Volume 3.
Hell yeah.
This guy uploads everything, dog.
See, he's awesome. He's exactly what I want. Just the biggest ADHD collection of bullshit NASCAR and motorsports related that you will ever see. Like, oh, you want to find the top five fucking Tim McCready Jr. crashes? Hell yeah, right here. You want?
Do you want to watch this? The exact same clip of Dale Earnhardt Jr. running out of gas at the Coca-Cola 600 30 times. You got your guy.
Do you want to watch the best Chad Chaffin moments? and this watch what the fuck moments in stadium super trucks back to back.
Hell yeah.
I'm looking at his uploads, and it's some of the craziest stuff ever. Just the variety. He has clips from Super Password, an old game show.
Number 3, Cletus McFarland, spinning out of the lead in the win at Long Beach last year.
Unbelievable.
What else? Yeah, he has Danica versus Milka Duno. Looking forward to that battle, that's a throwback.
Oh my god!
I can't wait. Can't wait for that epic rap battle of history.
I let you make that joke, Jeb, because that was a funny one.
Thank you.
Milka Duno versus Danica Patrick.
Dude, this YouTube video just being like, best of the SRX series, chaotic caution number 9, and then insane police chase ending. It's just like a whole bunch of weird... John West Townley's big crash.
He had a couple of those.
A video just called Kicking Rusty's Car, and it's just a whole bunch of kids kicking a balloon. No, Rusty Walrus.
Unbelievable.
I almost called him Rusty Walrus. Unbelievable.
Rusty doesn't deserve that slander, but you know what? We're going back underway.
We are, and it's Triffin and Braden again. And then it's William and David.
Michael Rosero's now found himself in the top 5 after being involved in that lap 1, turn 1 calamities. Thought about forcing it 3 on Cabrera. He's going to be side by side with Gary Waterworth through turn 1.
Oh, Triffin went way wide through the first corner. That's going to allow Movich to get around the outside here as they go through the first set of corners. Movich to the lead. 3 wide further back.
Oh, but a bumper cars.
Big Gary Waterworth gets turned Schmidt in front of everybody. Look out. This is going to stack everybody up. The track is completely blocked.
Oh, my goodness. We have another yellow.
Valentin, Gosselin, Oates, Frelick piled up here off of...
Darius has just stopped.
Darius is just hanging out, man.
Darius is doing the 0x challenge,
he's just waiting. Hello.
So it all starts... with the 79 of William Schmidt kind of checking up middle of turn 4 and causing just a massive stack up behind him, which promptly caused 4 or 5 cars to be stuck in the tire barrier.
I was like, we just watched Gary's spot.
You know, so this is really funny. Actually, we'll do it after we watch the replay of the wreck.
We're going to be following the 79 machine behind the Pepsi Chevrolet at Triffin.
It's just 5 nose to tail contacts.
Everything
after
just
one
gets
another
stacked up, man. Jack Painter got spun around.
Yeah, you can't respond to Schmidt kind of parking the bus.
You don't have any space. Oh no! Oh man! Everybody was able to navigate.
That's a free spot for the Polaroid machine, I think.
Jack Painter blinked out in reverse. He's back now. What a chaotic set of corners. This track is awesome, man.
This track is pretty cool, actually.
So I just want to say,
I'm not gonna lie, when I first saw this, I was like, I don't know, but like this is cool.
As we go through, as we watch the Darius Dagar clip, it just reminds me of the clip of the car driving through the countryside, like the jump scare.
It does.
It's so fucking funny, man.
Do you know that was a commercial that aired on like German TV?
Yeah.
And they had to pull it because, believe it or not, it was scaring people.
This is fucking great. That's so funny.
Darius just stopping.
And yeah, Darius just...
Hello. Can we get a shot of Darius's car looking at the field?
Yeah.
Is there a TV cam that best demonstrates just the look of Darius's car? No, like head on. I want to see the shark eyes. Hello.
He's just absolutely befuddled. That what he is witnessing.
That is my honest reaction.
Here, let's do it.
Oh my goodness. So true.
Per-tech.
Every once in a while, you just be the number 65 machine.
Just action, a story of 1,000 words with none.
Sorry, I just wanted to say, Matt, real quick. I'm really glad there's another yellow because I needed to address this, and I saw this the instant we went back to green. NASCAR Nixon, Frisky Nixon, has a YouTube video uploaded called Timmy Hill Pronounces City Names.
Holy shit.
It's a 32-second clip of him pronouncing city names. What? Like, why? What?
What city names does he pronounce in
the video? I don't know. I want to watch it right now.
Called Timmy Hill Pronouncing Video Names. Or city names. Yeah. So I said, prior to this race starting, that I'm hopeful that this race goes long because it'll just bridge the gap between time in between the race ending and Modern Warfare 2 coming out. And so far, so good. This race is taking, we're 40 minutes into the broadcast and not even halfway through, so let's keep it up, fellas. I'm having a great time.
All right.
Also more time to watch college football.
What about what about NFL football, man? It's on right now.
What about it? What about it?
The Ravens and the Buccaneers are tied at 10-10 in the third quarter. It's another absolute banger of Thursday Night Football.
You mean you're not watching Virginia Tech take it to NC State?
You mean you're not watching Timmy Hill pronounce his city names? By the way, half of the video is him trying to pronounce Boca Raton.
That's not even a hard one.
Baca Raton. Boca Raton, and then somebody off camera says Boca Raton, and he goes, "Oh, Boca Raton," and then like laughs it off.
I mean, the Intimidator has never raced at Boca Raton.
He also messed up Mesa, Arizona.
Oh,
I don't know how you do that.
Let's get a Ben Simmons stat line update. He's currently has in overtime. Nets are losing by 9 to the Dallas Mavericks. He currently has 7 points, 6 rebounds, 3 assists on 3-for-7 shooting with 4 personal fouls.
Precautions here at Sandown.
Why Christian Gamboa, why are you telling me
Christian
this?
Christian Gamboa has admitted to credit card fraud in the Puffer Zone Network chat. So do with that as you will.
Please.
Solutions LA employee.
That's a business expense, actually.
That is a business expense.
That is technically correct.
That's valid.
That is related to.
Culture.
Employee morale.
That's a culture thing.
Yeah, exactly. That's an employee morale cost.
Fun fact: I worked at an undisclosed company for 4 months. When I first got there, they hired somebody in human resources to work. They were the culture manager.
Yep.
And before I left, they were no longer with the company.
You ever just manage culture? I've made a mistake. I was like a lap behind.
We're
green
underway.
Flag's out, but we didn't really miss anything because the green flag's out now.
Oh, it's good.
They're.
Oh, come on.
You know what? We're just messing with you. We just had you. Oh, David Cabrera's almost wrecking. Michael
Rosero's in the
wrecking.
Wall. He was side by side with Gibson all the way through to turn 4, then kind of skated wide onto the grass. But we're so far so good otherwise.
That was a much cleaner one. I think they might have even restarted single file there. Yeah, these cameras are the shit. This is it. The dynamic TV. It works a lot better on the road courses compared to the ovals, I'll say. Oh, David Cabrera is completely blown the final corner.
How did he do that? He must have missed a shift.
He is way off into the grass, man. That
he was
same thing as what Joe Armstrong did.
Yeah, he was completely unsettled through turn 8, and then tried to get on the binders, and it just went away from him.
I think that's what that is. It's just when the car is unsettled that much, you just can't slow down in any way.
Yeah, it's just difficult.
Because you're just sliding.
Yeah, you've maxed out the shocks, and there's like nothing you can do other than just let it.
Not even that. It's like if you get on the brakes, you aren't slowing down. If you get on the brakes, you just go into the wall.
You're also just like in the air as you're braking and stuff.
That doesn't help either. Race kind of settling into a groove now. He says on lap 2 after a restart.
Yep. Rosero has gotten past Gibson after running wide at turn 3. Building up a little bit of a gap to Gibson already, even though it's still 2.5 seconds to William Schmidt in third.
front three have broken away here, just in their little own clique.
Why didn't I pick Driven Davis?
I don't know, but he just always finds himself up here at every point of these races, man. At the beginning, the middle, the end, he's always here, and he's very good on these road courses, as we've seen in Austral past.
Oh, there's a big game tonight.
There is.
Awesome. Utah at Washington State.
There sure is, and we're actually off this week because Rod is traveling to that. No, I'm kidding. That's not true.
He traveled as in he drove about probably half an hour, give or take.
Pullman.
Where's he going?
He's watching the game.
They're battling for fifth. That's Grindell and Gibson. Man. Oh, look at Gibson with the crossover. He cut it through the grass to try to make that work.
Hold tight alongside the 70 on the run out of the turn four into turn five. A little bit of a quick kink. Grindell gets all over the curves on the right-hand side of the corner, but it's going to give Gibson a bit of a run, and he's going to have the preferred line into 6, 7, and 8.
Still side-by-side. Oh, Pearson throws it in on the inside of Grindell. They make contact.
Bit optimistic.
Sure
going to give
was.
It back, though. At least he's a gentleman.
And that allows Gibson to get away.
Either quarter's going to capitalize on it, though, and go, oh, thanks!
Hey, man, I appreciate that. Grindell runs wide again. Quarter will take away that spot. He's up into the sixth place now.
That's a net loss of three positions for Grindell on that lap to Gibson, to Pearson, and to Quarter. An unfortunate run for the 70.
And you know what? Harry might have done that last corner on his own merit. I don't think he got help there. Who was at the one?
Marty Farrell has gone off. Oh, no. Let's take a look.
Did he do it again?
He
might have just caught the grass there, honestly.
It's like he just caught the grass.
Or maybe a little bit of wheel hop there, I don't know.
This track's looking a lot more difficult than I
anticipated. Oh, Cabrera just knocked the wall down out of that corner, out of turn three. He seems keeping on going, though. Man, he was way in the grass.
That's the advantage of these new damage model cars is sometimes they're quite forgiving, actually. Sometimes they very much aren't. But sometimes they are. In this case, they were.
As long as you don't break that right front, man. Gavin is just in the grass. He just loves to play in the grass, man.
Cabrera over the place.
Jesus Christ.
He keeps it together, though.
Why does he have a strip on his door?
Why not, man?
I guess. There's one of them. I love how there's grid spots that go all the way back to before that chicane.
That's awesome.
Imagine being like the guy who gets that grid spot.
For like some state categories, like the Hyundai XL Cup, yeah, there'll be like 40 cars on track.
Big run down to turn one. It seems that the draft's really playing out.
Here, Grindell. Oh, we had all sorts of stuff is going on. Oh, Gavin Newton spun. Oh, no, they're piling in. Josh Stoltz is there.
Oh, Gavin, oh!
He nearly comes back out in front of Mo Perry, who's battling Josh Gosselin. Everybody's seemed to figure it out. This is a lot of cars for...
At the 20th position.
20th position.
Hey, what, this race is actually working out to be quite a barn burner.
It really is. There's just action all over the place. So I was going to try to cut to Joe Armstrong and Harry Grindell as they're locking up a little further down the track. This is inside the top 10.
Ethan Quarter's also passed Gibson to go into the top five. Quarter probably has some of the freshest tires in the field. So far, we've seen him pit two or three times already. At the front of the field, Triffin Davis has cut down the gap a little bit into Braden Mavich. It was kind of hanging out about half a second ever since the restart. He's been trying to chip away at it, and we saw Mavich kind of get a good run through turn one and two there.
You can see with the onboard there with Triffin how aggressive the curbs are around here. I'm actually surprised he's still using them. It doesn't really seem like it's helping that much, but it's making it work.
Let's go on board for a lap. Let's go on. Let's just watch this lap on board here.
There's a bug on the windscreen.
Yeah, we're going to head down to turn 6, 7, 8, and 9 here. Turn 9 is the 90-degree left at the end of this run.
Go on the visor cam.
Thanks to Triffin for sporting this for us.
Yep.
Davis got a great run through 6, 7, 8. Got right to the back of the body armor 42, and then we see Mumish get a good drive off.
We weren't able to get GoPro sponsorship. Unfortunately, we're using Sony action cams.
This is 11, 12, and here is 13. Mavich is going to have to think about maybe playing a little bit defensive here, as Triffin is all in the draft right now.
Triffin actually just put a pop socket on his helmet with his phone attached to it, and that's how we're getting this footage.
Well, what did I see on Instagram today? Someone has made like a modification to like those aftermarket tail hooks you can get, to where it replaces the main piece of it with like a phone handle, so you can put like a GoPro or like your phone on it, so you can do like more dynamic onboard footage of other cars.
This is
a crossover.
I just want to. This is some of the most entertaining stuff on track right now. They're also battling up here. Oh man, that's Jonathan Oates and Bobby Blazer.
Going at it.
There's all sorts of on-track action right now. It's honestly tough to keep up with. There's all sorts of things changing on my ATVO screen. Josh Stolz, I think, just crashed.
Oh, no.
Yeah, he sure did. Oh. He locked up, and AJ Green gave him some assistance.
I mean,
Brayden Mavich is just under siege from Triffin Davis. There's so much. Oh, man.
And that's going to give William Schmidt a really good run out of turn 12 and turn 13. He's going to be side by side with Mavich and give Triffin Davis a push down the front straight.
They're going to go three wide down the front straight for the lead into turn
one.
Oh,
here we go. Schmidt throws it into turn one. He's
going to
turn all over the place. He's going to get into the grass on his right. He's going to maintain third place for now. Now comes Michael Rosero to try and get the spot from the 79. That was a bold move.
Absolute chaos here at Sandown.
He chucked that thing into turn one to try and make it work, but it was just not meant to be.
Mavich going to set his sights back on this 96 machine. I don't think he's completely out of this yet. I don't know. Are we going to have to pit again? I don't think we will, but we'll see. Joe Armstrong and James E. Gibson side by side here into turn six. Armstrong going to throw it into turn eight.
Oh,
he puts him in the sand.
Bit of a wishful move.
Gibson's going to have that one in his back pocket for later, next time he battles the 20, I think.
If there's anybody who's going to remember that move, it's going to be James Gibson. I can't blame him. I cannot fault him for that.
Mavich and Davis are side by side again. Rosero into the grass in the background.
Triffin has the preferred line through the this tight section, but he doesn't get a good drive off, and it's going to allow Mavich to take back the position, and it's giving William Schmidt a chance to catch up after bottling it up last lap.
Davis went into that turn four a little bit too hard, nearly ran into the back of the 42 and had to check up out of it. And that's what cost him all that time there. Now back down to an 8-second gap. So we're going to get 15 laps to go this time.
The good news is they're probably not going to have to stop again, unless they're taking tires. But if you're taking tires, you might as well take fuel.
Got trouble for David Cabrera.
That's also a spot for Christian Gamboa.
Oh, no.
Oh, he might have just wheel hopped, honestly.
We're going to see the Bahalaj. We saw the Bahalaj machine. He got a free spot.
I mean, Darius Dadgar?
Darius Dadgar, yes. Christian Gamboa is in the chat.
So there's your front three. Rosero's closing in, I guess you could say so. But
right, now we're settling down. Oh my!
Not as much with corners like that.
Might have gone a slowdown actually. They will give you slowdowns if you do stuff like that.
Got a little battle of four cars here. One of them a lap car. That's Josh Stolz in the Red Bull machine.
Try to get that lap back.
Stolz was involved in that stack up with Mo Perry coming out of turn 12. Kind of just not have the best day overall.
I think that we're kindly asking him to vacate the premises here, Harry Grindel will, and he does so. They're three wide further back. You see that? That's with Waterworth, that's Rudy Valentin, Ethan Stanley.
Oh, coming in through the S's. This will be an interesting
Stanley
spot. Stanley
overcooks it a little bit, takes the escape road, loses the spot to Waterworth for now.
See, what he did there was smart. He used the runoff to avoid absolutely destroying his race car. Apparently, some people don't get that.
It's always a great idea. You always want to do that.
I would actually argue that's why it's there.
Yeah, especially after, historically, that corner has seen a lot of just carnage in the actual supercar series.
There it is. It's on the screen.
Forgot that I didn't put it up, but, I mean, oh well. It's a logo. It's cool. It looks great.
Puffer Zone bingo cards at home.
Oh, Michael Rosero's in trouble. He's had
a
major incident there where he's been all over the place the last few laps.
What did he do there?
He just... Okay.
We got a rogue agent at turn three.
Trouble. Boom! Oh man, just hit the invisible wall right
that,
there.
And that didn't
just really
blow,
hate to see that.
That didn't blow the motor. That's impressive.
Oh, this is going to be a good camera here.
Oh man. Hopped out of nowhere.
Just a real shame for Michael and all the guys. That ghost right there.
I mean,
turn four.
If it didn't break his car, it actually might have saved him, because he would have gotten
There's
out
no
of the
damage
wall.
To it.
He is completely fine. That is absolutely bizarre. I'm sure that Ethan Corder saw that and was like, what the fuck just happened?
I cannot wait until, like, three laps from now, he just blows up on the back straight. Just phantom radiator damage.
All of a sudden, like, his temps just start rising.
Dude, the chicane at the end of the lap at Le Mans, I hit that with the center of the car once in LMP2. I was going down the back straight two laps later, and the engine just grenaded. I hit the floor so hard it broke the radiator. I don't even know how that happens. Is that Jonathan Oates with the...
Yes, it is.
He's trying to make up some ground.
I don't even think he touched him, actually.
No, Grindel's just kind of just been in no man's land for the last two corners and forced to give up a couple of spots here. He's lost a spot to Cole Fraley.
Oh, Brandon Momich is off and Davis through to the lead.
Oh, no.
What happened?
This really is probably one of the best Oslo road course races I've seen.
It sure is.
There's so much happening.
Was this a driver error? Oh, it sure was. You hate to see that.
Oh,
just a little bit of a wheel hop, and the only way you can kind of deal with a wheel hop is just get off the brakes and let the car restabilize, and it just sent him straight into the sand.
He didn't lose a ton of time out of it, but man, that is going to be a hard mountain for him to climb.
Yeah, it's 2.5 seconds, and he has to pass William Schmidt in 12 laps to get back to Davis. So it's quite the task if he wants win number four on the season.
Sorry, go ahead, Jeff.
I was just going to say, if he doesn't get it, he's still in for a podium. That's still good for some solid points for the championship.
These guys are
currently somewhere in the championship. I don't have the statistics. You might as well go ahead.
He's somewhere. You got a very good point. He's like in the top five. He missed three races, but he's also won three races. So like he is like gonna run the rest of the races and try to win the championship. So
which is sixth.
So with the drop, he is sixth in points, 51 behind Ethan Corder, who's on 261 right now. AJ Green is second in points on 240. William Schmidt's 31 behind Ethan. He's going to look to try and take advantage of the second place right now.
Oh, man, there's some chaos here. This is for the sixth position. Wesley Pearson going at it. All these guys are sideways. Cole Fralick, all sorts of fishtailing back there.
Matt, I've just discovered something very important in the statistics.
What's that?
If Triffin Davis wins this race, he will become Osterholz's winningest driver.
Oh, we did that like... We talked about that a couple of weeks ago.
I think we did.
And you know what, Jeb? You picked him for a race a couple of weeks ago because you said that he was going to become Osterholz's winningest driver.
That's true. And I think he got wrecked out on lap 20.
He got wrecked out very early in that race. So you didn't pick him this week, and he's probably going to end up making his dreams come true.
I mean, you know, Darius Dacos on pace for a solid top 25 finish.
Yeah, he's doing a great job. Oh, he just passed Gavin Newton for 24.
You know what? I just hope everybody has fun.
Can we get an incident point check for Darius Dadgar?
Let's get an incident point check. Will it tell me that? No, it won't. That's a shame.
No, probably won't.
It's a shame.
I'm going to assume a nice clean zero.
He might be getting, the goose.
He's 24th!
X.
Yes! He is in 24th.
Let's go.
He's doing a great job.
Glad.
Oh, they're locking it up. All these. Oh,
everybody.
Gibson and Fraley
locked it up.
Is there oil down in that corner?
The track is wet.
Everybody is missing that corner.
Boyer's on fire.
Oh, man. Gordon. Michael Waltrip.
That has to be a slowdown for Gibson. He ate that fucking corner. It's going to be just multiple battles here as we go down the front stretch. Just a little
Ethan
group of Porter seven
has lost a, Ethan Cora's lost like 6 or 7 seconds the last couple of laps. He's now behind Joe Armstrong.
He is. Oh, Rosero blows the first corner. Frelick into the grass.
Oh.
Uh-oh. Oh, boy.
Oh,
oh, yep. Oh, no. Oh, that was not
Throw
the
it.
Move. Oh, no.
That's a caution. We need a yellow.
Nah, they're gone. We got enough battles on track. We don't need a yellow. For the first time in a while, we do.
Yeah,
not
that's
need
very
a yellow.
True. We do. We don't need one.
Actually, IRP, we didn't need a yellow. We had some battles.
We had some good stuff going at IRP. They're and still side by side. They're still side by side again. I don't really remember
going.
It either. Gibson and yes. Ethan Stanley.
Stanley.
Oh no!
What a save by Stanley!
What a save by both of them, and that's going to allow Valentin to hop up here into the battle for the top 10.
Did they do something to these cars? Like, it just...
Oh, no! Gary Waterworth gets spun!
Oh, Gary Waterworth around.
See, this is what happens when you go to a new track that nobody knows in a car that people are not... I've said this before. These are not... These guys are not cracked out of their minds at road course racing. They're pretty good at oval racing, but they're not that good at road course racing. They don't do it a lot. So, new track, intermediate... Road course racers. Oh, Ethan Stanley. And get some chaos and some fun stuff.
And there's only going to be so much you can really gain from doing the AI racing and iRacing around here. You do need to kind of figure out how it's going to be against real people just because, like, that's just how it's going to be with AI. They're always going to be pretty predictable in their conveyance.
Another corner there.
This is for 10th, Valentin and Gibson.
Gibson really unstable under braking there.
He was trying to get everything out of that 75 machine.
You know, only 8 laps to go.
This thing is, time flies when you're having fun, let me tell you what.
Yeah, things normally get spicy near the end of the race, but I would argue things have been spicy for the entire duration of this race.
Yeah, they've been interesting. Ethan Porter is, as we said, he dropped back behind Joe Armstrong, back to fifth, but he's kind of just hovering around that 20 car. I think he's going to have a shot at him before this is said and done.
He's probably just taking a little bit of time, just kind of get the temperatures and his tires under control so he can get a good push in the last 5 laps. But it's 2 seconds from Triffin Davis to William Schmidt, and then another 3 from Schmidt to Mavich as they're passing Darius Dadgar. He's actually just letting a whole bunch of people go.
I just wanted to show everybody the face on the car again.
Oh, there he is.
Gibson and Valentin going to be side-by-side again.
Side-by-side through those S's is a very bold move.
Sure is.
Well, that's a cool camera.
It was. Oh, Valentin blows the corner. Is that the final corner? I don't know.
Is turn 9.
It looks. It reminds
me
of a
little bit of a short shoot.
It reminds me of the Bathurst final corner.
Yeah.
And it's got the fucking pin
really
right
does,
thing
actually.
At the end of it too.
That's
why.
Downhill.
Yeah.
Oh, Gibson getting a little bit elbows out. Terry Skadgar's pulled over.
You're just letting everybody by. Every man on every crew has been let through by Darius Dadgar.
I mean, I respect it. He sees their battle and he knows. Gibson. Oh, Gibson.
Gibson and Valentin are just switching places here, trading spouses.
Oh, I'm actually surprised they're able to get away with that, honestly.
Yeah,
they're going way wide.
Yeah,
no,
the
not
crazy
the
slowdown
spouses.
And stuff. No, the crazy. Yeah.
It's normally, I mean, even Watkins Glen, you get slowdowns for that.
Triffin Davis has had a bobble somewhere. He's lost a couple of seconds now. William Schmidt's still all over the back of the 79.
He's right there. What happened to Triffin? It might have been this corner. It was.
Well, completely locked up that front left and went straight off at turn 5.
So Schmidt down inside of a second now, and We'll see if he's got the pace to mess with him. And that was a lockup for Triffin, so those tires are not going to be optimal here. But William just threw it into that corner.
If he wants to break that record and become the winningest driver, he's really going to have to work for it for this race. He's going to hold him out for 6 laps. He's close enough. He's close enough. It's not going to be a ton, but he is going to be getting some draft.
We'll have to see. Davis opened up a couple of tenths over that set of corners. Be tough here. And all it takes is one mistake. And that corner, that 6-7-8 sequence is not ideal. It'll throw you for a whirl in no time. They're battling back here. It's Brian Lindau and Bobby Blazer. It's for 18th and 19th. I think Brian just took the spot away.
There's a Ravens running back hurt. That's a, you hate to see it.
Was it the Gus Bus again?
Yep. We have an interesting situation here, though, Matt. As I mentioned previously, if Davis wins, he'll become Austral's winningest driver. If Schmidt wins, this will be his maiden.
Oh, man, somebody just blew the corner. I think it was Darius.
No!
No!
Unbelievable.
Oh,
man.
He blew it. Yeah, oh, no. He missed
what
that.
A shame.
Oh, man.
He's still live, and he's not got going.
Get it going, buddy.
Oh, he's letting Marty go. Oh, now we go.
There we go.
Hey.
Continue your point about the front two here, Jeff.
Sorry, I was going to say, if Davis wins, he becomes Oswald's winningest driver. If Schmidt wins, he gets his maiden win. If both cars crash and flip and wreck and explode, and then Braden Mavich wins, he will become Oswald's fifth most win. He will be tied for Oswald's fourth most winningest driver.
It'll be his fourth win of the season and a 2 in a row.
Would that be the, I think, 4 wins in a season, that might be second on the single season wins list, or third, depending on how many Triffin won in his season 2 championship.
I don't have that statistic, but I wish I did.
I don't know, man.
All I know is he would then tie with Rudy for fourth.
We have 4 laps to go here. We're getting down and dirty, but Davis is continuing to open up that gap. It was only a tenth that Davis was ahead of Schmidt that last lap, but still, Schmidt not making up that gap in the time that he needs to.
Was Schmidt maybe slide it a little bit through there?
Just a bit, potentially. James Gibson is, way off!
Oh, how did he end up there?
He blew turn one, or this final turn completely.
Turn 8 into 9. He was all over the place through turn 5 and just never corralled it, man.
Whoa!
Yeah. Pow.
Honk.
Very soft pow.
Oh, I caught the lip. Anyway, let's rebound him. I got to turn after.
Oh! Yup.
I think there's a flat tire. Right?
Oh, my God. Look at the left rear. You can see it. It's flat. Or something's wrong with it. Oh, my God.
Oh, my. Something's wrong with that 18. Oh, Gibson.
Oh,
my
God.
Don't keep addressing the corner at speed. What's he doing?
Maybe he's doing this on purpose. I don't know.
He might be doing a bit.
It looks like the left rear is flat, though. Oh, man.
Was it?
Look at it.
Maybe.
Look at it. You can. It looks like it's lower than all the other corners and like the carts.
Looks like it's shifted over.
Yeah. It looks something's wrong.
I think
with
that's a track bar.
The rear end element is shifted.
That is a track bar.
It's a broken rear end. You just really hate to see that.
Formerly functioning track bar.
If it's a bit, then, I mean, we've been duped.
We've been bamboozled.
The good news is the track bar now moves more freely. The bad news is it's not under.
He does get out of the way of Triffin Davis, thankfully.
If he took Triffin out, I'm sorry. I think I would have just walked out. I would have to call.
This is scary. He's going to.
Come on, buddy.
There we go. He's a good Samaritan.
Oh, man.
Gibson knows right from wrong.
Gibson stressed me out. Welcome back, Ben Biller.
Thank you. I never left.
Oh.
I thought you went to Sonic for like 50 cent corn dog.
Did he stay out?
He did stay out. I just...
You know,
I mean, does he have a meatball?
There's two laps left. You know what? Like, I get it.
I mean, he's only going to need to do one. He's only going to need to do
one and a half.
Oh, no.
He nearly followed David Cabrera to no man's land at turn.
And Joe Armstrong here is on the lead lap. We got to be careful about him.
Both these cars are driving
honestly,
terrible right
now. Oh, my God, Gibson.
What's it?
Tokyo.
Oh, my goodness.
I just want to give a...
Like, imagine being behind this car. What do you do?
Otis is probably having a fucking heart attack as he drives by that.
I mean, I would too.
I want to give a call to Joe real quick. Sorry, Josh. I'll give a call to Joe here because he was all the way back to 25th place after that wreck that he was the catalyst of about the midway point of this race. He has raced his way under green all the way back up to 4th place. So props to Joe. Yeah. He has had a great run.
And at the same time, Jonathan Notes has rallied back. And now he's battling Ethan Quarter for 5th. But what I was going to say was... the next group of cars that was going to catch James E. Gibson was the battling group for 7th between Ethan Stanley and Wesley Pearson. So that was going to be a little bit of an awkward circumstance for 75.
We got a couple battles going on here as the white flag is out. You know, you got to... Time flies when you're having fun.
It really does.
Oh, man. Oh, it blows the corner. Oh, Ethan's not giving him an inch.
Ethan's... keeps the position for now, but looks like Oates has the preferred, the better rubber on this last lap.
So we look back up, here's Triffin Davis going through turns 6, 7, and 8. This is his last big obstacle, and he's through it. Darius Aguiar is going to win the race.
Yes!
Yeah!
My pick!
20 years of trying. It's been a dominant day for Darius Dadgar as he comes off the final corner. But it's really been a dominant day for Triffin Davis. And in our first unbelievable trip to Sandown, Triffin Davis is your winner of the SVG Stock Car Showdown.
His second win of the season. He won at Auto Club a couple of weeks ago. William Schmidt's going to come home in second place, get back into the championship battle. Braden Mubbage recovers for third. Joan Armstrong, fourth. Ethan Quarter survives the late attack from Oates to get fifth. Oates might have had a spin late there. He's going to come home sixth. Ethan Stanley's going to beat Wesley Pearson home once they get across the line.
Still got some battles finishing up here as we go further back. This is three cars going at it. Grindel 12th, Painter 13th, Rosero 14th. I think we have anything else. I don't think we have any other imminent battles going on.
I think Rosero's going to be a little bit disappointed with a 14th place finish. He was battling in the top five earlier on in the race and just kind of,
pow.
Kind of got away from him there.
And very importantly, everybody pre-order the diecast now. Because Triffin Davis has surpassed Justin Champagne to become Austral's winningest driver.
History.
Order the diecast now. We're taking pre-orders.
There he
and
is.
He's going to do Omega Donuts. Oh, he's almost going to put it in the wall. Or he's going to do donuts the other way because we're in Australia.
Oh, James T. Gibson is still doing his thing.
He's doing a skid, mate. He's doing a fat skid.
Oh. Well, Triffin Davis has won the race, and I want to say this. I hope Oswald goes back here for season 5. I will also be lobbying for other
an Australasia double dip when Puka Koei comes to IRA.
Oh yeah, man, we got to get we might have to just turn Austral into a supercar series.
That's true.
Maybe literally just become Austral. Be like, "G'day, mate."
V8.
Yeah, just we're just V8 scops, but Austral.
We literally just become fucking a V8 series. That's what we do. That's the new car, is a V8 supercar. If we want to change
Matt, no alcohol permitted in this area.
Fuck.
No.
Damn.
The home of horsepower.
It's true. I don't even think Triffin Davis is in Discord for his record-breaking interview. Oh, there he is.
He's in the
wrong channel. But...
Oh, I got pinged in broadcaster chat. I wonder what that's about. Oh, they're saying that my mic is clipping a lot. That was 22 minutes ago.
I'm glad to hear that. Well, the good news is that you didn't yell loud enough for that to take effect.
Okay, that's good. Okay, let's talk to Triffin, because he won the race. And yeah, he's your new all-time wins leader. Triffin Davis, you have gotten it done today at Sandown. It was, as we saw, quite an eventful race for everybody out there. Take me through where strategy was and how you were trying to navigate how chaotic that was, at least for the first half of that race. And then, yeah, take me through how you got that done.
Yeah, not bad for someone who's lost, huh? No, it was. I didn't really think it was much of a strategy. It was just stay out. We only ran like, what, 3 laps on the green up to that point. There was no point to get new tires. And then they changed the rules mid-race, and it worked out in our favor. I thought it wouldn't because it was still double file restarts, and you had to go out of the final corner, which puts second place at a huge disadvantage. But thankfully, I didn't slide my rear tires really bad once all race, so I saved them and worked out in the end. Made a mistake a couple times, but not as many as my competitors.
Triffin, I don't know if you know, but with that win, you're the all-time wins leader for Austral. How does that feel?
Yeah, indifferent.
Wow.
I mean, it's cool. Okay, yeah, it's cool, but I'm still thinking of the championship. And I mean, honestly, this could have been my final race until spring. So.
Ooh.
No.
You hate to see that.
I mean, I'll do my best to make the rest, but it's just things didn't exactly work out that way. But
hey, man, I get it.
Well, it's going out on a high note, at least.
Yeah, exactly. We saw a little bit of the fight for 50th. And well, Triffin, I want to say thank you for being here. Congratulations on your race win. Hopefully we do see you out here for the remainder of Season 5. And,
me too. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Congratulations. That was Triffin. They're saying that there was a fight at the line.
That felt like AJ Foyt announcing his retirement from Indy. I was not expecting that bombshell.
It's like, yeah, I'm not doing it anymore.
Unbelievable.
Second place, though. We're going to look at the battle for fifth here. But second place, William Schmidt is in the waiting room.
Oh,
that's what happened, Oates.
What happened? What'd he do?
He was facing nose first into the barrier after turn 12.
Bonk. Oh my goodness.
Uh-oh.
David Cabrera was messing things up.
There was hijinks.
They're calling Ethan Stanley a bitch. That's messed up.
Oh!
Unbelievable.
Oates gave him a little bit of assistance.
Oates
and
gets into him. Oh, they're banging. Oh, no.
They're beating. They're banging.
Oh, Oates. Oh.
What a dirty move.
Unbelievable.
This Ethan Carter guy is such a pizza.
I don't even know who got the final blow there. I mean,
I wonder who got the final
blow. Well, yeah, but they're both just swerving.
That's just racing, man. Rubin's racing.
That was a goofy old wreck.
I think next year you should go on the horse track.
I agree.
That'd be really funny. I mean, the Dover Sandown horse track double dip.
I kind of want a 3500 tow truck.
I kind of want to. Can every Austral race be at this track? This is a cool ass track.
But for now, we get to talk to second place, William Schmidt.
There he is.
William Schmidt, you brought it home second in today's Austral race at Sandown. It was quite chaotic for everybody out there. You were able to navigate your way up into the top three. Take me through your race. It looked like you might have a chance there to get up to Triffin, but just wasn't quite meant to be. Take me through your race and how you were able to get into this podium.
Well, I don't know what happened on the first lap. All I saw was a plume of smoke and everybody flinging and flying everywhere. So I think I gained a couple spots out of that. Then I don't remember if we had a run or if there was something else that happened after that, but a whole lot of people came to pit road, left me in like third or something. And that's kind of where I was for a little bit until we got that final run where we were pretty good on the short run. And there was a point where I think Tiffin or whoever was leading at the point like overshot a corner and they were double wide coming to the start finish line. And I saw the opportunity to go three and I'm like, do I really sacrifice my race for a cool screenshot? Hell yeah, I am. So I threw it down there, missed the corner, lost like 3 seconds, but we're going to get a cool screenshot of it. So it's not all that bad. And yeah, from there, I think Movic screwed up. He lost a lot of time and don't know. We were catching the 96, then I don't know. We just lost rear grip, and you just kind of scuttled away.
Well, that was that three wide going down the front stretch. That was a very cool cinematic. So we appreciate that for broadcasting purposes, that's for sure. And hey,
yeah, no problem.
A very good P2, and never complain with that. So hey, William, congratulations. We'll see you out next time.
All right, thank you.
That was William Schmidt. What a nice guy. Nice to talk to. Oh man, there was a deep pass in Thursday Night Football. So I'm conflicted here.
I just want to say, slight correction. If you want to get technical, William Schmidt has won an Austral race. It was duel number 2 for the Speedway 2-1.
That is very true. He was on the front row for that race with Ethan Corder, who that was his birthday.
That's true. That's why it was called
it was the Ethan Corder birthday bonanza duels.
Everybody please wish him a happy birthday.
To be fair, GT Porsche, he did grab him by the face mask as the ball was coming.
That's a terrible penalty, though.
Is it?
Yes.
So I have a I'm conflicted because Braden Melvich is live streaming in the waiting room, but
what if we all join them?
No, we don't move the booth for other people.
That's true. That's literally impossible. We got all the equipment set up in here.
But cutting their stream and broadcast or whatever they're doing short is a little rude, man.
What if we just don't interview Braden because we've already interviewed him like 7 times this year?
What if I just drag him in here?
And what if we do that too?
What if we talk to Jonathan Oates now that he's been?
Let's talk to Jonathan
now that he's been cleared from the medical center after his wreck on the last lap.
Talk to Oates, then ask him if we can drag Muffich in.
Hey, Jonathan, how's it going, man?
It's going all right. I thought that race was I don't know. It looked like one of those that was. I had fun. I know a lot of people didn't have fun, and probably was pretty fun to broadcast. So
Certainly very fun to broadcast. That was a very entertaining last lap battle between you and Ethan as well.
Oh, yeah.
It didn't end up very well for you.
Nah, he kind of keeps misjudging his way into me. He wrecked me at IRP, then tried to run me over, and wheel spun into my door and slammed me into a wall today. So I think beef. The score is 0-3, which is, I'm not too happy about that. And, I'm going to leave it at that.
We'll see. That's the points leader.
You should punch him in the face in the paddock.
Is there something else I can help with?
Oh, I turned my Siri on.
Oops. Yeah, punch him in the face in the paddock.
No.
Hey, do you have unbelievable. Is Siri a male for you?
Yeah, I changed it to an Australian guy.
Yeah, it's very
committing to the
theme. That's very themed. Yeah, I appreciate that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Dude, is that you got to change it? We'll do that now for every Australian race. If we go to like Florida and make it a southern accent.
Yeah.
Well, hey, Jonathan. Thanks for coming in here and talking to us.
No problem. I thought you guys might want to, have a little chat with me about the last lap. I've definitely wanted to say something about it for a while. Maybe that makes me petty, but I don't know.
Hey,
it feels
like
a little
that.
Uneven to me.
I like that. We're all about voicing your opinion here at the Puffer Zone Network. So we'll see you out next time, Jonathan.
Yeah. Where are we next week? Like Chicago?
That's Gateway.
I love Gateway.
Gateway.
That's going to be fun. Win that race.
I'm gonna try. Yeah, I love Gateway. Probably my favorite track.
I saw the World 360K, and I thought we were running 360 miles at Gateway, and I was about to be like, "Why?"
No, wrong track. It's at Chicagoland.
Yeah,
no.
Okay, yeah. That was. I think you can understand why I was stressed.
Yeah.
All right. Cool.
Well, hey, Jonathan. We'll see you next week at Gateway. Maybe you'll be in Victory Lane for that one. We'll be interviewing.
I've been waiting to try and win one of these races for a while, and I haven't won one since Rockingham season 2.
God, that was a long time ago. Yeah.
Yeah, it was.
I remember that race. That was
like 10 years ago.
That was 15 years ago, actually. It's crazy.
It was a good battle, though. So I'm proud of that win, but I want to get another one. So hopefully Gateway. Got that one circled.
Hell yeah, Jonathan. Well, we'll see you then. Or do you want to say something, Ben?
No.
Okay. Well, you'll see you, Jonathan. God bless.
Was season 2 earlier this year?
Season
3.
It was at the end of last year.
All right.
I think.
That was your one.
I'm gonna bring in Ethan Corder real quick just to get his opinion on that final incident too. I'm not gonna pull in Braden Movich. I'm gonna let him hang out there in the waiting room. Ethan, Jonathan Oates voiced his opinion on the last lap incident, so I wanted you to get the chance to voice your opinion on the last lap incident.
Oh, beef.
I think it was just good hard racing.
I agree, But yeah, go ahead.
He's pretty biased because, you know, I had a couple of incidents with him last week, but yeah, I thought that was just good racing, you know. And you know, to be fair, he did give me a bump, so he started it. We're gonna leave it at that.
Wow, that's unbelievable. Should I rate Prime Video?
No.
Yes.
What about I think it's high school football.
Every single play.
It's Tom Brady is not happy with how things are going.
Are y'all not gonna
What about Rough Rider Sports?
They he's streaming. Can we drag
he's
him?
Streaming. It's awkward.
Football.
No. He's fucking taking pictures.
Oh, okay.
Hey, yeah, Brayden, you finished third. Oh my god. Hey, Brayden. Hey, Brayden.
What's up? Holy crap.
You finished third, and so we saw your streamer down there in the waiting room, and we didn't want to interrupt that, but you were just taking pictures apparently. So take me through your race. You were leading, and then you weren't, and then you blew the corner, and then you weren't leading, and then yeah, take me through your race.
So yeah, I feel like that I blew the pole. I mean, I was gonna get it by about 300ths, but I blew the same corner I blew in the race. Then after I blew the corner and lost the lead to Triffin, it was basically all over from there. But I finally figured out how to drive into turn 9 after that, which was kind of pointless. But yeah, I surprised myself. I had no idea that I was gonna be leading like legit laps at a road course, because I will be the first to say that I'm not really like great at road courses or anything. So I was kind of surprised by my pace. But yeah, I'm kind of annoyed and happy with the P3, but I mean, that's just the way it goes sometimes.
Hey man, that's another solid points day as you try to leap into the points battle for the championship. So
I heard there was like some protests gonna happen. I don't know. But
uh-oh. No.
Beef.
Wow.
So I was telling Oates, like, remember the beef. Remember last week, Oates, because I wanted him to ship the hell out of you.
Wow. Unbelievable.
So the quote-unquote protest is that...
I don't even know.
Because I was supposed to get a lap hold from my...
Yeah, that's what everyone was like, yeah, you're supposed to get a lap hold.
Dorman gave me a drive-through because first lap. So, but I don't think it would have mattered.
Yeah, I don't think it would have. But, like, Dorman said to me that, like... If he said this to me, if he knew a penalty was going to help me, he is not giving it out. So,
wow, unbelievable from Robert Dorman. You know,
this is a short track showdown all over again.
Your lack of bias here. That's what we're all about. We're gonna send the people over to Rough Rider Sports. They're doing college football. Brayden, thanks for being here, man. Congratulations on your third place finish.
Thank you.
Are we talking like DMX Rough Rider?
Yes. Rest in peace. Oh. Great song.
Yeah, rest in peace.
It's an anthem.
Stop.
Yeah, rest in peace.
Drop.
Oh, no, but I'm stop. I'm not pretend. Like, no.
Oh.
That's all I got.
So, here at the Puffer Zone Network, we're off tomorrow. It's Halloween weekend.
No,
so,
it's not, but.
It's Halloween weekend. So, go and, like, get
it's not
fucking.
It's Monday.
Dress up and get fucked up or something. I don't know. Shut up, Bachelor.
Candy watch.
Might have to do the
second candy.
One.
Don't put fentanyl in your candy that you're putting
out.
That's
not real.
If you put up,
that's not a real thing.
No, it is. I saw it on the news that everybody in my local town is going to be putting fentanyl in the
food.
Okay. I remember if you guys see a candy bowl that says please only take one. Please only take one.
Take the entire bowl. Steal the bowl.
Do not take the lighter if there's a lighter.
If you don't know what to put in the bowl, cigarettes are always a good option. The little tiny things, a fireball, that's a pretty solid option.
Yep.
What else?
Hey, we're gonna. It's good.
Live Tic Tacs.
Goodbye. God bless. Be it.